September 6, 2022, Daily Devotion.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son to make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of tearing loss, the Father turns His face away. For the chosen one, bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon the cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed, I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is in anything, no gifts, no power, no wisdom, but I will boast in Jesus Christ, His death and resurrection. Why should I gain from His reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, His wounds have paid my ransom. Why should I gain from His reward? I cannot give an answer, but this I know with all my heart, His wounds have paid my ransom.
For our scripture reading today, please read Ezekiel chapter 4 verses 1 to 13, chapter 12 verses 3 to 6, and 2 Timothy chapter 4 verses 1 to 5. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 5. As for you, always be sober-minded, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. Difficult assignments. The passages today describe the things Ezekiel had to do to portray the messages of the Lord. From shaving his head to baking food over dung, lying down on one side for more than a year, food rationing, to building model cities and siege works around them. I admire Ezekiel for his obedience to such difficult tasks. Last year, I volunteered for Jubilee School's monthly Zoom meeting with teachers. It aims to bring the knowledge of God deeper to the teachers. My job was to facilitate one of the breakout groups. As a naturally quiet and shy person, I had to muster courage each month to talk. I breathed a sigh of relief when the school year was over. With the opening of a new school year, we were asked to do face-to-face this time. With cases of COVID on the rise again, and with monkeypox threatening the horizon, I had more reasons not to volunteer again. On the day of the first physical meeting, I was contemplating resigning from the task. My Bible readings that day happen to be in 2 Timothy. I will share part of the verses that leaped out of the pages. 2 Timothy chapter 4 verses 1 to 2 and 5. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, and exhort with complete patience and teaching. As for you, always be sober-minded, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. Needless to say, with those words, I'm glad God is not making do what He commanded Ezekiel to do. No cooking food over dung, no shaving of hair, no digging of walls. Still, with fear and trembling, I commit again to another year of service for the school's monthly meets, looking forward to how God will strengthen and help me as I make Him known to our school's precious teachers. Reflection. How have you responded when God has asked you to do something outside of your comfort zone? Prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, it is by grace we have been saved through faith, and this is not of ourselves. It is your gift, not by works, so that we cannot boast in anything. For we are your workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which you prepared in advance for us to do. Please give us the willingness, strength, and ability to fulfill our purpose. Do not abandon the work of your hands. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.